Hey everyone, Mitch coming in from the Chimera's Core studio. Welcome to the show. So, really quick, if you haven't seen my most recent episode, well, I guess it was at the end of the day yesterday, but still decently recent, make sure you check that one out on Blade Whip. Oh, I'm gonna mess up this name again. Transmogrant? Let's go with that, because, wow, this card is gonna be quite popular. But don't leave just yet, because on this episode, we've got an incredibly spicy card that you're gonna have to see to believe. But before we jump into it, as always, blame it in case I make any mistakes on this episode, and yeah, let's jump into it. So first up, a big thank you to MTG Goldfish for the translated version of this card. Fateful Cooperation is a sorcery for 3 and a black, and it says, choose target artifact or creature you control. Draw cards equal to its mana value. An opponent gains control of that permanent. So donating one of our things to one of our opponents is not the type of thing we see all that often in Magic cards. Now, there are cards out there that do that. We'll talk about some of them here in a bit. But yeah, it's a pretty unique effect and one that, well, can really be used and abused. And with this one especially, since you can get an absurd amount of value out of this card, again, depending on how big that mana value is for that artifact or creature, you can draw a ton of cards with this on top of giving one of your opponents maybe something that they actually don't want. Now, obviously, there might be some circumstances where you utilize this and give them something that is of, you know, moderate value or, you know, some value because you desperately need to draw a ton of cards. And definitely, you definitely can do that. And kind of along those lines as well, with, you know, Commander being a multiplayer format, you can definitely make a deal with an opponent and be like, hey, I really need to draw some cards. I've got this 6 mana value creature in play. That's actually pretty decent. If I give you this creature, you cannot attack me with it for the rest of the game or until we're down to a one-on-one situation. You can only use it to attack the other players. And yeah, if you don't make that deal with me, I'm going to make it with this other player and they're going to be attacking you with that creature. So there are most definitely ways to politic with this. So yeah, a politic strategy might be able to utilize it. Or more so, yeah, obviously too, a bad gift strategy where you have certain artifacts and creatures in your deck that you're going to be getting into play and giving to your opponents that have very negative effects for them. So yeah, again, this is basically a donate card essentially with massive upside because you can draw a lot of cards with something like this. So yeah, I would say that's a pretty spicy card and one I definitely did not expect to see this spoiler season. Now also do keep in mind though, again, this one is a bit more specific than some other donate effects. This one does specify artifact or creature. So unfortunately, yeah, there are certain types of permanents that we can't give our opponents that we would really like to be able to give to them. But now with all that said, let's jump into the cards that, well, this can work well with and some that it's reminiscent of. First up, yeah, obviously the inspiration for this card. I've kind of already mentioned the word a couple of times because, yeah, I believe donate was the original donate card. That would make sense, right? Target player gains control of target permanent you control. And Harmless Offering basically does the exact same thing. Target opponent gains control of target permanent you control. And yeah, basically, again, a major difference between these, I mean, outside of, you know, being in different colors than Fateful Cooperation, is that, well, they cost one less and you can pick any permanent you control. It does not have to specifically be an artifact or creature. Now, that being said, obviously, Fateful Cooperation, you know, has the upside of also drawing you some cards too, and in some cases, a massive amount of cards. So that one extra mana can definitely be worth it, and yeah, that extra, you know, restriction essentially, that you can only pick artifacts or creatures. At the end of the day, I'd say if Fateful Cooperation is drawing you, you know, 3 cards, it's probably on par with a bunch of, you know, draw effects essentially that are already utilized. And in fact, I mean, those, you know, like an Ancient Craving are going to lose you life. So instead of losing life, you're more so, you know, just giving away a permanent, which again, might be beneficial to an opponent. Or again, you can politic it and make it more beneficial to you. Or again, it might be detrimental to that opponent. That being said, one of those things that you will not be donating with Fateful Cooperation, unfortunately, is Demonic Pact. Because, yeah, again, it specifically says artifact or creature, which is kind of disappointing. I mean, I'm not sure Yeah, I mean, maybe, you know, they had to restrict it a bit more because of the amount of card draw that you could get, or just because a lot of the things that you want to donate tend to be, you know, these kinds of enchantments. I mean, there aren't, you know, all that many, but there are some very, very good ones. Demonic Pact says, beginning of your upkeep, choose one that hasn't been chosen. Demonic Pact deals 4 damage to target creature or player, and you gain 4 life. Target opponent discards 2 cards. Draw 2 cards. You lose the game. Basically, yeah, just use up the 3 modes that you like, and then donate it before that last mode goes off. So then that opponent that you gave this to just loses the game. Yeah, that would be a great combination. Unfortunately, Fateful Cooperation does not work in the same way that, again, Donate or Harmless Offering do. But still, again, it does have that upside of drawing you cards, so it kind of makes up for that in a way. That being said, of course, there are still some fantastic things that you can donate. Well, fantastic for you to give to other opponents, not fantastic for them to want to keep around. Lich's Doom is one of them, an artifact for 4 that says you don't lose the game for having 0 less life. So see, you're helping your opponent. Oh, but whenever you lose life, sacrifice a permanent for each 1 life you lost. So that opponent better hope that they are dealt, you know, a small amount of damage so they can sacrifice, you know, Lich's Doom or, you know, a couple of other things, essentially. Before, you know, if they're just hit for a massive amount of damage at once, they're going to be losing a lot of things and probably the game from just one hit. And also, yeah, I mean, 4 mana, draw 4 cards, you know, by getting that Lich's Tomb to an opponent, sounds pretty good to me. Next up, Grafted Skullcap can be brutal against certain decks. An artifact for 4 that says, beginning of your draw step, draw a card. So see, you're helping that opponent. Oh, but at the end of your turn, discard your hand. So massive downside again, especially for control decks that love to hold on to cards. Another kind of card to consider, though, might be one like Spine of Ishsa that kind of just gives you its value on the ETB, and giving it to an opponent really does nothing for them. And in fact, well, if it's ever dealt with, it actually just comes back to you anyway. Spine of Ishsa is an artifact for 7, so again, draw 7 cards for 4 mana. That is massive. When it enters the battlefield, destroy target permanent, so you already got that value out of it. And again, when it's put in a graveyard from the battlefield, return it to its owner's hand, it's coming back to your hand if it's ever dealt with. So yeah, you just get extra value out of it. Or how about Ingenuity Engine, an artifact that has Cascade, and again, this one costs 7 too, so yeah, draw 7 cards. Also, yeah, when you cast this, get something off the top of your library that costs, you know, 6 or less, essentially. Cast it for free. And it also has pay 1, tap, sacrifice an artifact, return target artifact you control to its owner's hand. If you're playing against an opponent that really doesn't have a lot of artifacts or cares about getting artifacts back in their hand, giving them this essentially does, well, nothing for them. And again, you already got the value out of it, and even more value when you drew those 7 cards. Speaking of drawing, how about something like Fawn of Mythos? At the beginning of each player's draw step, the player draws 2 additional cards. Now certain decks really like these Howling Mine type of effects, and this one's just basically a double Howling Mine. This one is just kind of like, it applies to everyone. It doesn't matter who controls this artifact. It has the exact same effect no matter who has it. So yeah, I mean, donating it to another player basically does nothing except it just gives you an extra 4 cards. So yeah, Fateful Cooperation can be utilized in a couple of different ways depending on the situation and depending on the types of cards it's working with. Now when it comes to creatures, let's start off with artifact creatures like Steel Golem, Gridmonder, and Rust Elemental. Steel Golem says, you can't play creature spells, so this can be an incredibly brutal card that can really shut down some creature-based strategies out there. Again, you're going to be drawing 3 cards for it, so yeah, 4 cards for 3 mana. Or, I said that in reverse. It's a quick take, sorry. 3 cards for 4 mana. That's, again, a pretty, you know, pretty much the going rate for what you're going to be drawing anyways, you know, with like an Ancient Craving. But at the same time, giving an opponent this can, again, shut them down. So yeah, Gridmonder, again, costs 1 more. Even better in this situation, a 4-6, you can't play creature spells. Now, keep in mind, obviously, you know, with creatures, they are more susceptible to being taken out because, well, if an opponent is attacked by someone else, you know, they can block with these and, you know, maybe, you know, just lose it instead of having to take it out themselves with a spell. But yeah, you might be able to get your other opponents on board, you know, to not, and you know, be able to take out those, essentially, to ensure that they stay in play and keep that player shut down. Speaking of shutting a player down, though, how about Rust Elemental, a 4-4 flyer that says, beginning of your upkeep, sacrifice an artifact other than Rust Elemental. If you can't, tap Rust Elemental and you lose 4 life. This can be a good way over time to just get rid of someone's artifacts. Again, they're up to sacrifice artifact after artifact after artifact. They can't sacrifice this one. And again, when I said, you know, when it comes to blocking with, you know, Steel Golem or Grid Monitor, this player can't because, well, Rust Elemental is going to be tapped and you lose 4 life after that happens. Or at least, again, I should say it can't in that circumstance. You know what I mean? Moving on, a creature that an opponent definitely can't block with is Bronze Bombshell, a 4-1 that says whenever a player other than Bronze Bombshell's owner controls it, that player sacrifices it. If the player does, it deals 7 damage to them. Basically, hey, yeah, pay 4 mana, draw 4 cards, give this to an opponent, hit them in the face for 7. Sounds like a pretty good deal. Or again, how about a creature that doesn't really care who's controlling it? Silent Arbiter says no more than one creature can attack each combat, no more than one creature can block each combat. Again, it has that exact same effect no matter who has it. So donate this to an opponent, draw 4 cards, and be on your way. Or how about a creature like Meteor Golem, which is kind of like a Spine of Ishtar, but you really already got your value out of it too? It says when it enters the battlefield, destroy target non-land permanent opponent controls. Again, this is the main function of this card, is a 3-3. Sure, that's nice, but giving someone a 3-3 is not all that big of a deal, especially when you're drawing 7 cards and you already got that ETB value out of it. So yeah, something to consider. Again, there are negative impacts on opponents, there are, you know, just neutral impacts on your opponents, and then there's also just like a slight benefit, but not really. So keep all that in mind. But perhaps the funniest thing you can give an opponent is Abyssal Persecutor, a 6-6 flampling demon that says, you can't win the game and your opponents can't lose the game. This can be really funny to give an opponent, especially when you're in a 1-on-1 scenario towards the end of the game, because if they don't get rid of it, well, you can't lose and they can't win. So yeah, just donate this to an opponent with your new card, draw 4 cards, and have fun watching them squirm. Also have fun watching them try to do things when they've got Evil Eye of Orms by Gore in play. Yeah, it's an eye creature, this is weird. Anyways, non-eye creatures you control can't attack, and it can't be blocked except by walls. So sure, you're giving an opponent a 3-6 unblockable creature, but again, you are drawing 5 cards by doing so, and also, they can't attack with anything else. I mean, okay, I guess if they have, you know, Eye Tribal, you might be in trouble, but no one runs that. Or, you know, if they've got Shapeshifters, yeah, don't give it to the Changeling player, okay? But still, for the most part, basically you're going to shut down all their other attacks. And speaking of shutting things down, another card that you might want to give your opponents is Asmodeus the Archfiend. It says if you would draw a card, exile the top card of your library face down instead, pay black, 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 draw 7 cards, and pay a black, return all cards exiled with it to their owner's hand, and you lose that much life. By giving this to an opponent, if they don't have any way to produce black mana, they can be in big trouble because essentially, well, you can shut them down from ever essentially drawing a card again until they can get rid of it. And if they can't get rid of it, well, they're not going to be able to draw cards to get rid of it because this just exiles cards that they're going to be drawing. So yeah, this can be a very brutal play that can draw you a ton of cards. Speaking of some brutal plays though, how about, you know, a smaller creature like Ebondrake, a 3-3 flyer that says whenever a player plays a spell, you lose 1 life. Yeah, and a format like Commander, plenty of players are going to play a lot of spells, so that player is going to drain quite quickly. And yeah, I mean, just having this 3-3 flyer, sure, you can have a 3-3 flyer. Have fun swinging at someone. Does not matter. You are going to lose life quicker than me. Speaking of losing things, how about Phyrexian Negator, which has, when it's dealt damage, sacrifice that many permanents. That player better hope there isn't a Blasphemous Act cast at some point, otherwise it is game over for them. Yeah, this is a card that is very, very risky to have on the field under your control, so have fun donating that to an opponent. Or maybe something like a Master of the Feast. Yeah, it's a 5-5 flying demon, but it does say at the beginning of your upkeep, each opponent draws a card. So this can really gain you some favor from the other players at the table, and that player that you're giving this to, well, might feel a little left out since they're not drawing any extra cards and everyone else benefits from you giving this away to them. And yeah, I mean, draw your 3 cards as well by giving this to them too. Again, the going rate for 4 mana is drawing 3 cards for the most part when it comes to a card. Again, like an Ancient Craving, etc., etc., etc. Now when it comes to a commander that might want to utilize this card, I mean, the first one that came to my mind is Blim, Comedic Genius, a 4-3 flying imp that says when it deals combat damage to a player, that player gains control of target permanent you control, then each player loses life and discards cards equal to the number of permanents they control but don't own. So yeah, Blim decks are all too familiar with bad gifts, giving your opponents things that they really don't want, and now you've got one other card, you know, to add to that, one other card that can help you give away even more bad gifts, and one other card that can give you a ton of card advantage when you do so with the right cards. So yeah, I can definitely see Blim decks slamming this card in there, and I can see Zedru decks being a little sad that this wasn't in a different color because, well, Zedru decks also love giving bad gifts too. But now, as this episode is coming to a close, it's time for me to give you my final thoughts on Fateful Cooperation. Yeah, in my opinion, this is definitely a very spicy card, one that I definitely did not expect to see in this set. I mean, there is, again, that restriction on it. Hey, it has to be an artifact or a creature. It's not like those other donate effects that are just any permanent. I mean, the major downside to that is, you know, you just can't give away certain enchantments that you really might want to give away, you know, like a demonic pact or whatever that card is. But yeah, drawing cards equal to the amount of value can be huge. So yeah, there can be some massive plays with this, some very exciting plays with this, where you give away, you know, something you really don't want, and that player really doesn't want either, and you also draw a lot of cards with it. Or again, just giving away a Spine of Ishtar can be a fantastic play, drawing a ton of cards, giving your opponent a card that basically does nothing for them. Or on the other hand, yeah, Queen Marchesa is probably one I should have brought up too. I'm bringing it up now, okay? Anyways, it's early. Yeah, like a Politics Commander could utilize this too. Hey, I'll give you this creature. It's a pretty good creature. I'll draw some cards off of it. Use that creature against our other opponents, okay? So yeah, I can definitely see some players, especially Blim players out there, being very excited about this card. And yeah, for more exciting cards and spoilers and quick takes, make sure you stay tuned to the channel because there will be more coming up. And with that, the show has come to a close, so it's my turn to hear from you. So make sure you comment below and let me know what your thoughts on this episode are. And as always, thanks again and have a good one. This show and episodes like this one are possible thanks to viewers like you. If you're looking for an easy way to help support this show, make sure that you like, share, and subscribe. Also, hit that bell notification icon so you don't miss any new episodes. You can also go check out our playmats and other merchandise at thecommanderquarters.com. We also have a ton of brand new t-shirt designs in stock, so make sure you check out those as well. Another easy way to support this show is with our TCG player affiliate links. So whether you're buying a deck or individual cards, you can use this general link right here or one in the description. And the final way that you can support this show is by supporting us directly by becoming a patron. There are many benefits to being a patron, and I truly couldn't do this without all their support.